In this video, we will describe what restriction enzymes are and what makes them useful cloning tools. Restriction enzymes were identified in bacteria in the 1970s. There is a microscopic war continually going on that most humans are unaware of. This is the battle for life between bacteriophage and bacteria. Bacteriophage are small viruses that infect bacteria. After injecting its DNA into the host bacterium, the bacteriophage takes control of the host cell's replication machinery. However, bacteria have evolved mechanisms to protect themselves. One of these mechanisms is the restriction and modification system. There are two important parts to the restriction and modification system. The first is the restriction enzyme. In order to defend themselves from the bacteriophage, bacteria have evolved sequence-specific DNA endonucleases. The restriction enzyme cuts the bacteriophage DNA into small fragments, preventing the bacteriophage from replicating. There are thousands of bacteria which contain restriction enzymes. The characteristics that make restriction enzymes useful in cloning are that they have specific recognition sites, cleavage occurs at a specific location within the recognition site, resulting in predictable sequences at the point of DNA cleavage. Cleavage is sequence specific. However, different enzymes cut at different locations within the recognition sequence, resulting in three different types of ends. In the top example, you can see the 5' protruding end generated by HindI-3 cleavage. In comparison, PST cuts farther along the 3' strand of its recognition sequence, creating a 3' protruding end after cleavage. A third example is when the enzyme cuts in the middle of the recognition sequence, creating a blunt end. Cloning with restriction enzymes is made possible by the enzyme DNA ligase. In the lab, purified DNA ligase is used to covalently rejoin the ends of DNA together. Restriction cloning is conceptually as simple as cut and paste. Because it has been around for such a long time, an expanded arsenal of vectors exist. Any one of these might only need a modest change to produce the clone you need for your experiment. In general, the reagents used in restriction cloning are inexpensive, and there is no need for specialized equipment. Restriction cloning is not flexible. You need to find sites that are convenient for your cloning project. As a result, there are now over 600 commercially available restriction enzymes. Not all enzymes work with equal efficiency. Some enzymes are simply more finicky than others and prone to incomplete digests or star activity. Because we are dependent on the location of restriction sites relative to the fragments we are cloning, extraneous sequences are often carried along in constructs. In addition, many cloning projects require incorporation of multiple fragments to create the desired construct. This can take considerable time when using restriction cloning. To learn more about molecular cloning, visit snapgene.com.